Obviously, GDPR is the big thing.
Absolutely.
That came into effect on the 25th of May. And really, I guess the message is don't panic. It's not a hard and fast regulation. Yes, it started on the 25th of May. Companies need to just make sure they're doing the right thing as far as GDPR is concerned, doing the right thing as far as people's data is concerned, and then making sure that they follow the rules. The other key thing for a lot of buyers across EMEA is safety and security. Obviously, we've had a lot of incidents in EMEA over the last 18 months or so, which is unfortunate, and therefore safety and security is on the top of people's minds. And that question comes back time and time again. Growth is a key factor for us across EMEA. We find that companies are continuing to invest in the value of face-to-face. I personally agree with that as well. We're bombarded with lots of information on social media, but I think companies are finding that if they spend a little bit more of their marketing mix on live events and face-to-face, that the message is getting through to people a lot better than just social media, and it creates a lot of engagement as well. So that's another key factor for us. I guess the one I'm trying to avoid talking about is Brexit. So Brexit really for us as an industry is business as usual. So I think for the UK in particular, we saw a devaluation of the pound after the vote, which did attract a lot of inbound business from the US and from other European markets as well. So London has seen a continued strength within the meeting and events industry. The hotel prices have remained pretty much the same, but of course with the currency difference, then it's become a lot more attractive to other origins. I think for us, then Asia always has the drawback of the travel time. So we've got to overcome that question up front about the travel time. And I think there's ways that we can do that. But I think what, you know, DMCs, what hoteliers, what other agencies wanting to work with us and some of our clients should be doing is talking a lot more about the overall experience here. Everybody knows that Thailand, Singapore, a number of other Asian markets are high quality, high service levels, great properties available, and we can see all that on the internet. What they don't know is what are the local experiences that we can create? What are some of the corporate social responsibility activities that corporates can get involved in? How can we give stuff back to the community? And those are key selling points which can often sway a major corporate as to whether they go to one destination or another. Compliance is a key factor for a lot of our major customers. That's why they work with a large global corporate as opposed to a multiple number of smaller agencies. Compliance is a key factor, and that is nowhere more true than somewhere like the pharma industry. One of the challenges that we face frequently is not getting the right level of data that feeds back into the systems for which we analyze reports on a monthly basis to run programs. So those companies that can be compliant with the data, handle the data correctly, input it into the technology that they're using in such a way that we can extract it, definitely have a head start.